We ensure the quality of beer by tasting it. We don't send it off to labs, but the quality of beer is very important to us. We taste it all the time. If it's not Charles and I, we're always, you know, coming in every morning, just smelling it, tasting it. If we did send it off to labs, you know, that would be something that I would think bigger breweries might do or probably would do to find out whether there's, you know, any bacteria in their beer, you know, especially if you're sending it out mass quantities. But, you know, unfortunately, we taste it. We take our gravity readings. We hope everything's right. And then in the end result, it's a taste. And if it's not what we want, you see me cry when I dump 434 gallons down the drain, you know. So it's kind of a tough process.
There's a lot more, you know, to ensure quality. It starts just like with any chef or anybody that creates something. There's a recipe. And so the first step is find the recipe you like, which is done through smaller batches. We figure out what we're looking for. We have a goal of a flavor. We create a recipe. We all shake hands and agree, this is the recipe. And Mark and the brewing staff make sure they follow the recipe. So it starts with making sure that we're getting the right ingredients, you know, from the trucks, that we're getting grain and hops from producers that can give us a consistent product, that we're monitoring that product as it comes in off the trucks. That we're mixing the product at the right you know, measurements before we grist it and make the beer, that we're cleaning things. And then he's right, we taste beer, you know, and that's the fun part of it. And because we don't pasteurize our beer or, you know, for a shipment across the country, you always have a risk of a beer turning, you know, because it is what it is. You know, it's not, you know, we don't have a lot of protections to it. We are making a craft product. And so it's important that we taste the beer, and, you know, many people laugh about that and volunteer for that job quite often, but, you know, we've got to smell it. Smell is a big part. One of the first things that happens with flaws in beers is you can smell it. A lot of times you can smell it before you can taste it. So we taste the beer, we smell it regularly, I'd say almost daily. You know, if not, I bet I taste all of our beers at least 4 or 5 times a week. And we look at them, you know, visual. We want to make sure that they're bright and clear. What's important for us to sell beer in America is Americans want bright, crisp, clear beers. They want them really cold, and they want them overcarbonated. If you're a European, you know, in Europe, they like them the way they came, with that natural carbonation, so it's almost kind of flat. They don't have a lot of refrigeration there, higher temperature. That's European beer. We sell American beer in America, and we like it overcarbonated and probably at a temperature that mask some of the real flavors of the beer that we do, but that's what we're selling. We're selling it to Americans. But that's how we quality control. We get to taste it, look it, follow recipes, clean, all those things.